Welcome to this video series on NRF Connect for VS Code. My name is Robin M. Saltness. I am a product marketing engineer here at Nordic Semiconductor. I will be your guide into the world of NRF Connect for VS Code throughout the series. In this video, we will cover the installation of NRF Connect for VS Code and the NRF Connect SDK. The first thing we have to do is install NRF command line tools. To do that, we follow the link displayed on the screen and scroll down to the Downloads tab. Select your operating system and the latest version. Click on the file name to start the download. To start the installation process, we open the downloaded.exe file. You may also be asked to install a Segger J-Link driver. Go ahead with that when prompted. The next thing we have to do is install NRF Connect SDK. Installing the SDK is now done through the NRF Connect for VS Code extension. To utilize this, we first have to download and install VS Code itself. This link takes us to code.visualstudio.com, where we can download the VS Code installer file. Select the version that matches your operating system. Open the downloaded.exe file to continue the installation. VS Code opens automatically upon completion. The next step is to install the NRF Connect for VS Code extension pack. To do that, we go to the Extensions tab on VS Code and we search for NRF Connect. Then we select the NRF Connect for VS Code extension pack as our install. This will install all the relevant NRF extensions in VS Code. Once installed, we open the NRF Connect for VS Code extension and select Install Toolchain. It's always recommended to install the latest toolchain available. Once the toolchain is installed, we also need to install the NRF Connect SDK. To do that, we click on Manage SDKs, select an action, in this case Install SDK, and install the latest tagged release of the NRF Connect SDK. We also need to select a directory for our installation. Good practice is to keep the file name short and keep the install path as close to the root of your system as possible. Downloading the SDK may take some time depending on the speed of your internet connection. We have now completed setting up our development environment. In the next video, we will learn how to create a new application. Happy coding!